In this question on graphical solution to quadratic equation, we are asked to copy and complete the table of values below this one here for the equation y is equal to x squared minus 2x minus 3. And then using a scale of 2 centimeters to 1 unit on the x axis and 2 centimeters to 5 units on y axis, we are to draw the graph of that quadratic equation. Then using the same scale and axis, we should draw the graph of y is equal to 1 minus 3. So this is a linear equation, as opposed to the quadratic equation that we are looking at before. Then from the graph, we should find the root of the equation x squared minus 2x minus 3 is equal to 1 minus 3x, and the minimum value of y and the corresponding value of x. Good. This is quite cut out for us as our work to do. And what I would like to do first is, in the first case, we should copy and complete the table of values below for y is x squared minus 2x minus 3. So we are to complete this table, well noted, but looking at the question C, we are asked to also draw the graph of y is equal to 1 minus 3. So we need a table for this in filling this particular table that they ask us to do, but we also need to generate the table for this equation. So I'm going to show you manually how to go about doing those stuff. If you are looking for a quick way to do that using your calculator, you can check our other videos on graphical solution to quadratic equation, trigonometric functions, in which you will directly use your calculator to just fill in the values for the y on the table. But here, let's do this manually so that you can also master how to do that. So here, I have the table, the template for the table that I want to use, and I'll be using blue ink for the quadratic equation y is equal to x squared minus 2x minus 3, and then this brown ink for the equation y is equal to 1 minus 3x. So what are we doing here? We are taking the entities for the quadratic equation x squared. We have x squared minus 2x minus 2x and minus 3 and minus 3. So we will take all those values and then we are going to sum them to get the value for y, and we'll confirm with the values that we are given already. So like in the first case, when x is minus 2, x squared will be 4, okay? Then minus 2 times x will be minus 2 times minus 2. That will also be 4, because minus will multiply each other to be plus, then 2 times 2 will be 4. Minus 3 is going to be a constant all through, so I can just append that as a constant all through. You can see it's not depending on the variable, it's just a constant that is minus 3, all like that. So I'm still coming to, okay, I can just even add this straight. 4 plus 4 is 8. 8 minus 3 is 5, so the value of y here is 5. When x is minus 1, x squared is 1, because that is minus 1 raised to the power 2. The negative sign we multiply each other to be a positive sign, and 1 times 1 is 1. Minus 2x will be minus 2 times minus 1, and that will be 2, okay? Then x squared, when x is 0, x squared will be 0, minus 2x will also be 0, and you can see the constant minus 3, when we add all everything, it will be minus 3. Here, 1 plus 2 minus 3. 1 plus 2 is 3. 3 minus 3 is 0. Okay? Then here, when x is 1, x squared will also be 1. Minus 2x will be minus 2 times 1, and that will be minus 2. So the sum of 1 minus 2 and minus 3 will be 1 minus 2 is minus 1. Minus 1 minus 3 is minus 4. So this is minus 4. When x is 2, x squared will be 4. Minus 2x will be minus 4. And then we have minus 3 as a constant. The addition of the 3, 4 minus 4 is 0, 0 minus 3 is minus 3, okay? So you can see how this is going now. When x is 3, x squared will be 9, minus 2x will be minus 6, 9 minus 6 is 3, 3 minus 3 is 0. And so that is a good test that all the values we have here are actually on point, because we are also consistent with the minus 3 and 0 that we are given originally. So we also need to evaluate for the case in which we are looking for y is equal to 1 minus 3x. So 1 is a constant, is not depending on x. You can just have that a constant all true. Okay. When x is minus 2, minus 3x will be minus 3 times minus 2. The negative sign will multiply each other to be positive. Then 3 times 2 will be 6. So this will be 6. When x is minus 1, minus 3x will be minus 3 times minus 1, and that will be 3. When x is 0, minus 3x will be 0. Any number multiplying 0 is 0. When x is 1, minus 3x will be minus 3. when x is 2, minus 3x will be minus 6. And when x is 3, minus 3x will be minus 9. So for us to find y for this particular linear equation, y is equal to 1 minus 3x. We just sum this value in brown. So 1 plus 6, that will be 7. 1 plus 3, that will be 4. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 minus 3 is minus 2. 1 minus 6, this is minus 5. And 1 minus 9, this is minus 8. So these are the set of values that we are going to use to compute our graph as requested in the question, and that's what we are going to do right about now. So here we have our table of values, and we'll be given the scale that 2 centimeters should represent 1 unit on the x-axis and 2 centimeters to 5 units on the y-axis. For me, I'll be taking from here to here as 2 centimeters, okay? So that will be what will be representing on the y, on the x-axis, 1 unit, okay? And on the y, from here to here, that's my 2 centimeters, and it will be representing 5 units on the y-axis. So I just want you to take note of that so that you can be on the same page when I'll be constructing my diagram. Now, for the values of x and y, you can see that from x, we have minus 2 to 3. It's as if we are even having minus 3 to 3. So that should actually be centralized. And for the y, look at this. The highest value is 7. The lowest value is minus 8. We are also having it just as if it is centralized. So we can look at the center of the graph to take our origin from there. So that's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to say, here, I can just look for a means of centralizing the y-axis and the x-axis. So there and here. So I can say I have this to be my y-axis. That's a positive y. And here will be the positive x. Okay. Now, for my 2 centimeters to represent 1 unit, I'm going to have 0 at the origin. This is 2 centimeters. So this is 1 unit, another 2 centimeters, 2 units, another 2 centimeters. This is 3 units. Here I have minus 1, minus 2, and minus 3. Okay. Then on the y axis, 2 centimeters to 5 units. So here this will be 5. And next, I'm going to have 10. And here, I will have, this will be minus 5. And this will be minus 10. So, that is a good representation of what I want to do. I can now go ahead to juxtapose those values. And I'm going to also be consistent with the ink. Blue will be for the quadratic equation. And brown will be for the linear equation. So, for the quadratic equation, when x is minus 2, you can see this is minus 2 here. X is minus 2. So here, y is 5. So y is 5 here. What I just need to note is the point of intersection of the two. So I can just trace that from 2. Okay, and then from 5. This point of intersection here is going to be the point that is relating x minus 2 and y is 5. When x is minus 1, y is 0. So x is minus 1 here, but y is 0, so it is with the origin. So this point is a point of interest. When x is 0, y is minus 3. Now this is what we need to do. Look at the division of boxes I have here. I have 10 divisions. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. So I can see that 10 divisions is corresponding to 5 units, okay, because that's what we are told. 2 centimeters to 5 units, and 2 centimeters consists of 10 divisions. So, what is going to correspond to, what divisions is going to correspond to 1 unit? I can just cross multiply, and the division that will correspond to 1 unit, I can see, will be 10 over 5, and that will be 2. So, 2 divisions like here, 1, 2, then this is 1, another 1, 2, this is 2, 1, 2, this is 3, 1, 2, this is 4. So I have minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, like this. I did that for us to just be on the same page. So now the next value, we have when x is 0, y is minus 3. So x is 0, y is minus 3, minus 1, minus 2, and minus 3 here. So this point is a point of interest that we are looking for. Okay, when x is 1, x is 1 here, y is minus 4. Minus 4 is just going to be here, just before 5. So, x is 1 and y is minus 4 here. Okay, and then when x is 2, y is minus 3. Again, we are going back to minus 3 here. X is 2, y is minus 3. Okay, and then when x is 3, y is 0. X is 3 and y is 0. So, just this particular final point on our graph, that is what that is going to look like. So, I can just note the inclination. This is coming from here to 1. And then this is 3 to 0 and 3 to 2. So, those are the values that we needed for this particular quadratic graph. And we can now go ahead and just join those points together. You can see that is already looking like a curve. You can just make use of your French curve to get all of these together. And I'm going to also try my very best to ensure that I link them together as appropriate. So let's see how that will go. So for the other linear graph, when x is minus 2, y is 7. So this is minus 2, 5, we have 6, we have 7 here. Okay, so I can just note that as being here. Then when x is minus 1 here, y is 4. 4 is just 2 boxes before 5, so this is 4. When x is 0, y is 1. X is 0 here, y is 1, it's just here, okay? And when x is 1, y is minus 2. When x is 1 here, y is minus 2. This is minus 2. I will say marked just before here. When x is 2, y is minus 5. This is 2 and this is minus 5. And when x is 3, y is minus 8. 3 minus 8, this is minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, and minus 8 here. Okay. So, all you just need to do is to join them with a straight line. And I think that is good. But then, our quadratic graph is not extending to the point that it needs to extend to. So, we still need to actually take it further. I like the fact that this is appearing like this. So, you know that you still need to finish up your curve to continue beyond the value that you are giving. And what I will normally do, what I would recommend students to do is that when x is minus 3, what is the value for y? So for the quadratic graph, we have y is equal to x squared minus 2x minus 3. So when you want to just look for some other value, like when x is minus 3, so that we can actually find the point of intersection with this linear graph, what will be the value for y? Y will be minus 3 raised to the power 2 minus 2 times minus 3. Then minus 3. Minus 3 raised to the power 2 is 9. Then minus 2 times minus 3 is plus 6. Then we have minus 3. So 9 plus 6 minus 3 is 9 plus 6 is 15. 15 minus 3 is 12. So what we have on the graph will be that when x is minus 3, y is 12. So 12 is just going to be here. That is 11 and here. That is 12. So this point is what we are looking at, and we can just extend this particular curve to that point, and that will be a better means of getting that value rather than just drawing the line as if it's a straight line. Okay, so if you are to do that, we just have something like this. I think that is quite interesting. Okay. And I think that is just fitting in with the previous curve that we have. So now you can see that we have two points of intersection that can help us to solve for the question that we asked, that we should find the solution when the quadratic equation is equal to the linear equation. So as a rule of thumb, it is good that you should always label your graph. So here, this is the graph for y is equal to 1 minus 3x. That's the one in brown. And for the one in blue, it is y is equal to x squared minus 2x minus 3. Now, furthermore, we have to find the roots of the equation that is given as what I'm going to write right now, the equation x squared minus 2x minus 3 is equal to 1 minus 3x. Now, if you look at this particular graph, you can see that this is just a statement of where the two graphs, where they are equal. And that is why they are saying that the quadratic graph is equal to the linear graph. So that is the point in which we have the two graphs crossing each other. Here, this is the first one. And here, this is the second one. Okay. And what for us to just get that, what we need to do is to trace down to the x-axis and we'll find that particular value. So in the first case, we just need to look at this red and trace down, just straight down to the x-axis. And in the second case, we also need to take this and move it to the x-axis. So the point of interest, that is the root of the equation, is this point and this point. And if you look critically, you know, we are having the whole of this to be a unit. So if this is minus 2 and this is minus 3, we have a gradation of 0.1. So minus 2.1, minus 2.2, minus 2.3, minus 2.4, minus 2.5, minus 2.6. So this is, they are minus 2.6. And on this other side, we have 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4, 1.5, and 1.6, and 1.6. So those are the roots of the equation that we can get for the expression x squared minus 2x minus 3 is equal to 1 minus 3x. Okay. Then finally, we are also asked to find the minimum value of y. So, and the corresponding value for x. So, minimum value for y, minimum value of y. I think for the quadratic equation, for x squared minus 2x minus 3 is, look at this curve. You can see that this is the least value and is corresponding to minus 4. In short, from the table, if you consider this, you can see that it is when x is 1, that y is minus 4 for the particular quadratic equation. And that means that minimum value of y is minus 4 and the corresponding value of x is just obtained as 1. Okay, so these are the kind of videos that we constantly upload on DevTutor Academy so that they can help you to build your proficiency in your STEM subject and be the best that God had created it to be. If you are yet to subscribe to the channel, it is free of charge and it's not going to cost you anything, but you will have information and access to all of our videos once we upload them. So go ahead and subscribe to the channel, click on the like button, click on the notification bell so that you have notifications of our videos once we upload them. And until next time, God bless you.